Okay, there is another question by one of the reader, and the question is, how is it decided that how many resource elements are utilized for control or to carry data in LTE? So this question requires some understanding of how radio LTE air interface operates and what are the foundations for radio LTE radio interface. However, in order to answer this question, I would just describe a scenario over here. First of all, how it is decided, just to give you an idea, there are a number of factors. When a UE or a user is connected to the eNodeB, so let's say this is the user, it is continuously sending CQI report. It is also sending scheduling request if it needs to send any data in the uplink. SR represents scheduling request, CQI represents for channel quality indication. So these requests tell the eNodeB, because the scheduler resides in the eNodeB, it gives information to the eNodeB that how many resources are needed in the uplink side, what resources does it needs to schedule for the uplink. Similarly, based on CQI value, eNodeB can decide what modulation coding scheme to be used if there is any data coming for a user. And based on the reference signal measurements, based on channel measurements, eNodeB can decide what is the state from the perspective of time and frequency domain where the users are, and if a lot of users needs to be served, how many resources to be allocated, what should be the modulation coding scheme to be allocated. Now, just to revisit the question again, the question is asking how it is decided how many resources to allocate for control and to carry data. So what I mentioned initially was just how to allocate resources for the data. If a lot of users are being connected and a lot of users are requesting resources, then it makes sense by default, or it makes sense logically, that there will be more number of control resources being needed in order to accommodate these users, because if more users are sending in their requests, more control resources will be needed as well. So in case of LTE, in one subframe, if you have idea or information about LTE air interface, we have a control region and data region in each subframe. So in control region, you can only have max up to, in each subframe, there are 14 OFDM symbols, assuming you have normal cyclic prefix. And in each subframe, there is a control region and data region. So in case if there is a lot of congestion in the network, meaning a lot of users are requesting resources, that the control region can have number of symbols, OFDM symbols, anywhere between 1 to 4. If more users are requesting resources or more users needs to be scheduled, then recommendations say you can have 2 or 3 OFDM symbols dedicated for the control region, meaning in control region, there will be up to 3 dedicated OFDM symbols in each subframe for control region, and the rest will be for data region. In case if there are not enough users being scheduled, then rather than having 2 to 3, we can just have 1 OFDM symbol for control region, and the rest of the region will be available for data region. So this can be changed dynamically after every 1 millisecond, because in case of LTE, scheduling takes place after every 1 millisecond. So after every 1 millisecond, scheduler can decide based on the scheduling load, based on how much information does it need to schedule. So after every 1 millisecond, it can decide dynamically, does it needs to allocate 1 OFDM symbol for control region in each subframe, or does it needs to allocate 2 OFDM symbols or 3 OFDM symbols, or for lower markets, does it need to allocate 4 OFDM symbols? That is the standard specified in 3GPP. You can have anywhere between 1 to 4. 3 or 4 you will have max, in case when you have more number of users to be scheduled, when more signaling information needs to be used for scheduling. If there are not enough number of users to be scheduled, then you can use only 1 OFDM symbols, and remaining 13 OFDM symbols you can be scheduled for data region. In that case, you will have more information or more number of OFDM symbols available for data region. So it's a trade-off. Max you can go up to 4 OFDM symbols, minimum you always needs to have 1 OFDM symbol at least. Having said that, as I said, based on the user's input as well, CQI report, scheduling request, scheduler makes decision. Not only that, this picture gives you better information as well. and I would write it over here specifically that after every 1 millisecond, scheduler is going to see how many resources does it have available, what are the reports coming back from the UE, how many users are waiting, what are the PDCCH resources available, which user has a higher priority over the other, taking all this into account. After every 1 millisecond, scheduler is going to make a decision how many OFDM symbols needs to be allocated out of 4 for control region and remaining needs to be allocated for data region. So to answer this question simple way, it depends on the load and number of inputs which are coming in. However, for control region, you will never be able to exceed more than 4 OFDM symbols. Let's just say if you're using 4 OFDM symbols, you will maximum have 10 OFDM symbols. You can increase it from 10 all the way up to, let's just say, 13 as well, because 13 will be used when you are using just 1 OFDM symbol for control. And when you are using 10, that means you are using 4 OFDM symbol for control region. So that is for your control, and the top one is for your data region. So that can be the decision maker based on how much, it's just like a knob, how you are going to control based on how much is the load in each subframe or in each millisecond. And that's done dynamically by the eNodeB scheduler in the eNodeB. So those are the metrics which are used by the scheduler in order to make sure how much resources needs to be allocated for control and to carry data region on the air interface.